Indrajit Saraswat would like to welcome everyone watching this presentation right now. The International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking, also known as the World Drug Day, is celebrated annually on June 26th. The day is dedicated to eradicating drug abusers and neutralize the systematic challenges that sustain the illegal drug use.
The assignments are completed. It's almost time for tuition. Now I need to go. Hello, Iman.
Roshmeet, carry some money today as we will have fun after the tuition class gets over. As it is the first class after lockdown, we will have fun. Tell your parents you will be late for half an hour.
Okay, let's see if I can borrow some money from my parents.
Roshmeet, have you brought the money that Iman told you?
Yes, I have some money.
Hey, Shashwat, let's take Saugata to somewhere where no one can see us.
Wait, why?
It's a surprise for you.
First, take out the packet that I gave you.
Roshmeet, give me your bag, I will give you something.
No! Don't give me anything!
Wait, it's a special thing for you. Oh yes, give me the money first.
But tell me, what's the special thing?
It's heroin. Take it and you may enjoy it.
Drugs? No, don't give me all these stupid things.
Chill brother, just take it to your home, sniff it at night and tell us if you enjoyed or not.
Let's try it once.
You look bit different today.
Yes, I'm taking something very nice. And exciting.
What are you taking? Tell us.
God, you are taking drugs.
Roshmeet, you're very good in academics and have a bright future. So don't spoil your future by getting into these stupid things and ruining your life.
You are going in wrong direction.
Roshmeet keeps taking drugs and gets addicted to it. He is unable to concentrate in his studies. However, he sits for his exam. But he fails. Roshmeet is shocked to see that he is failed in his boards. His health deteriorating, so he visits the doctor.
Well, I see that there is a drug overdose in your body. Your body needs rest and you need to stop taking these harmful substances. I'll give you certain medication that you need to take regularly. And I'll suggest you see a therapist who can help you in treating these conditions.
Drug and alcohol or abuse can be devastating to a person's health and academic performance. To be more specific, getting intoxicated can have a negative impact on cognitive functions like concentration, memory, and attention. Roshmeet now realizes that he has done a big mistake by getting intoxicated.
I should have listened to Titashi and Dhitaruk. They have tried to guide me in the right direction. But I refused to listen to them. Now I am suffering.
Drug abuse. Drug abuse is the non-permissive consumption of certain substances that may lead to physical and psychological dependence. Popularized in 1960s by music and mass media, they invade all aspects of society. Commonly abused drugs are marijuana, cocaine, heroin, alcohol, prescription drugs, inhalant and solvents. Sometimes, sedatives, coffee, and cigarettes can also be used to harmful excess. Hard and soft drugs. Hard drugs are physically addictive and may be easy to overdose on. Soft drugs are not physically addictive. Hard drugs such as heroin, morphine, cocaine, nicotine. Soft drugs are cannabis, LSD, mescaline, etc. Caffeine, ketamine, MDMA are both. The different kinds of illegal drugs are split into three classes, A, B and C. Each class carries a different level of punishment for possession and dealing. Class A, ecstasy, LSD, heroin, cocaine, crack, magic mushroom, possession. Up to 7 years in prison or unlimited fine or both. Dealing. Up to life in prison or an unlimited fine or both. Class B. Amphetamines, methylphenidate, etc. Possession. Up to 5 years in prison, an unlimited fine or both. Dealing. Up to 14 years in prison or an unlimited fine or both. Class C. Cannabis, tranquilizers, some painkillers, GHB, ketamine. Possession. Up to 2 years in prison or an unlimited fine or both. Dealing. Up to 14 years in prison or an unlimited fine or both. Why do people use drugs? Curiosity, stress, poor self-image, anger, fit-in, rejection. Effect of drug abuse. Drug abuse leads to loss of coordination, poor judgment, slowed reflexes, distorted vision, memory loss, blackout. Drug abuse or addiction is one of the most common chronic and compulsive disorder that requires formal treatment. Drug abuse changes a person's brain chemistry, and the longer the one uses it, the more damage they pose for themselves.
डरती आंखें सोने से कुछ भी नहीं बदलेगा अब मेरे रोने धोने से कहां तक मैं आ गया हूं वो पहले खिलौने से लड़ूंगा मैं खुद से दिन दे दे बस थोड़े से कैसे मांगू माफी हकी है गुस्ताखी हाँ मुझे पता मैंने तुझे दुख दिया है काफी तूने तो हमेशा बस चाहा था मेरा भला पर मैंने आपा खोकर तेरा पकड़ लिया गला कि पैसे दे मुझे ये तलब मुझे तड़पाती है तूने गले से लगा कर कहा ये बर्बादी है मुझे लगा हो गया हूँ कैद तेरे पल्लू में ये ना समझा इस गुलामी की तू ही आजादी है।
My name is Kritnaskar. I read in class 6B. Every year 26 June is observed as International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking to make people aware about drug use and the illegal drug trade as they are disorientation among a majority of the youth. It was first observed in the year 1989. This day is used to stimulate a sense of responsibility among the people across the world, especially among youngsters and teenagers, to stay away from the drug mains. Events are organized in schools, colleges, workplaces, public places, etc., to make people aware of the whole issue and the dangers which subsequently get spread by the mess of drugs and their uses by the people. Thank you.
First of all, I would like to thank to Juliande School teachers and students, myself, Niloy Chatterjee from Bongiyo Samaj Bengaluru, designated as State Secretary Coordination as Social Welfare Organization. having more than 14 lakhs members in India and abroad. Our organization aimed for general public, administrative authorities towards the support on education, treatment, awareness, culture through legal procedure. Today's subject is very much sensitive and harmful effective as issue is drug abuse and illicit. Drug has mainly two part. Number one part is prescriptive, that is when it is used in medicine, and another part is illicit, that is self-limitation part. Now illicit part, what is illicit part? Illicit part is alcohol, bath salts, cocaine, crack, heroin, ketamine, marijuana, etc. Prescriptive drug, Adderall, Ambien, Ativan, hydrocodone, oxycodone. Drug addiction can be defined as a chronic relapsing illness, and individual develops a physical and psychological dependence despite the knowledge of detrimental consequences. Drug misuse, abuse and addiction has two effects. One is short-term effect, another is long-term effect. Short-term effect such as change in appetite, sleeplessness, increased heart rate, loss of coordination, etc. Now, long-term effects. Depression, anxiety, panic, disorders, increased aggression. Now, drug abuse, society and family impacts. Drug abuse affects family and friends. The effect on individuals, families, friends and society include the risk and danger associated with a powerful, highly addictive stimulant that affects the central nervous system, and the problems associated with the drug trafficking industry worldwide. Now, a part is government-oriented, is having Ministry of Social Justice and Empowerment has been implementing the scheme of prevention of alcoholism and substance, that is drug abuse, since 1985 to 86, and the Drug and Cosmetic Act 1940, with up to 2016 amendments. There are several amendments done. Last amendment was in 2016. Now, mainly NGO part, the main thrust of these programs is to be strengthen their ties of addicts to their families and community, and get the community to cooperate in the rehabilitation process. Thanks and regards to all of you for your patience.
My name is Priya Paul. I am from class 8B. Today I am going to recite a poem on drug abuse and illicit trafficking. A downhill spiral because of meth. Once you are addicted, it can lead to death. It will rot your teeth, put spots on your face, put you in a position of shame and disgrace. It will lift you up just to throw you down into a sea of despair and torment to drown. Thank you.
Legally banned in most of the world, yet its consumption is increasing rapidly day by day. Drug addiction is not the right thing. The widespread consumption of drugs, especially among the youth of the society, causes various mental and physical distortions. Not only among the teenagers and adolescents, but the usage is also common among the middle-aged people, putting their family and livelihood at a stake. The International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking is yet to be celebrated on the 26th of June. This day brings together all the significant concerns from all across the globe so that they can unite and fight as a team against the widespread consumption and addiction of drugs. The United Nations organization heads the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking. Mostly the health organizations come up with the effective policies to curb widespread drug abuse. Drugs have severe impacts and consequences on the life of the consumers. Once one falls in the pit hole of drug addiction, it becomes increasingly difficult to retreat. Keeping in mind such factors, such a day is celebrated on June 26th. Thank you.
I would like to welcome a social activist and an actor, Mr. Bobby Chakraborty. He is an actor for the last 19 years in TV, films and theatre in Hindi, Bengali and English, academically a marine engineer for ExxonMobil, a teacher of method acting at SMPAI, social activist fighting against addiction and harmful popular trends among the youth all around the world. Winner of Shrestha Shamman 2015, Ashadharon 2016, both from the hands of our governor, Sri Keshorinath Tripathi. Banglar Gorbho 2019, Executive Committee Member of West Bengal Federation of United Nations Association.
Hello everybody, this goes out for all my dear soldiers from Julian Day School, Kolkata, as well as all the other Julianites, as well as everyone who's hearing this. June 26th, as it has been marked by the General Assembly of the United Nations as the International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking. Well, I heartily, wholeheartedly welcome this approach. I wholeheartedly support this approach. But at the same time, there is one part of me, a huge part of me, who doesn't quite support this fact that one day can be marked as this International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking and all the vices that we talk about, Anti-Tobacco Day, and one day cannot be marked against these universal vices, evils, which are destroying millions and millions of families, boys, girls, men, women, as we are speaking just now. So it should be a cause that should be marked every day, every moment in everybody's lives. But well, a good cause, nevertheless, even if it is for one day of the year. Now, let me come to the word drug. There's a huge misconception and misunderstanding of this word drug, of the words drug addicts, of the word or the phrase drug abuse, or for that matter, my social awareness program. Why I'm telling you that people misunderstand, people have a misconception? I don't know. Even if I'm writing it out everywhere in capital letters, even if I'm shouting my lungs out everywhere, in every interview, in every session, that this awareness program, as you see, as you can understand, is not against what you think drug is. Drug abuse. It's not an anti-drug awareness program or an awareness session that I do all around the world. It is much beyond that. Your understanding of the word drug is much beyond your misunderstanding or the conception that you have. That I'll try to clear it up in very easy way, in layman's term, in colloquial way. Drugs. In my understanding, in my learning, the word drug means any chemical that you put inside your body, either inject it or ingest it. Any chemical that will alter, that will change the abnormal functions into a normal function. Like, example, if you are sick, if you are running fever, you ingest a chemical that will normalize the temperature of your body. So that is one drug. And there are other chemicals which you ingest or you inject inside, or you sniff, somehow you put it inside your body, your bloodstream. What happens is the normal system of your body abnormalizes. It becomes abnormal. That is the word drug. So you can understand, drug doesn't only mean heroin and LSD and marijuana and all the other things which we call drug, which we say that he or she is abusing themselves with drugs. And we are very complacent about the other chemicals that we are injecting and ingesting and puffing and sniffing. They are not drugs. That is the misconception. That is what I'm trying to clear up. This day, if you mark even one day, it's not only against heroin and LSD and marijuana and all the, you know, drugs that we hear about. So-and-so has done drugs. And so that person is a drug addict. And you are not. That is not the case. So, coming to the base of everything, if you smoke a cigarette, that is a drug. Because the chemicals inside the cigarette, it's doing exactly that. It's somehow curbing the natural flow or the natural system of your body into unnatural happenings inside, abnormalizing your normal situation or the normal state of your body. So cigarette is a drug. So everyone who smokes or everyone who is hearing this, a smoker, he or she is a drug addict. Alcohol. It's a major drug that is causing mayhem everywhere. Everywhere. People who are listening, people who don't care. I know people don't care. I can understand. I'm seeing it. I've seen it in my own family. I've seen educated people. I've seen seemingly educated people. I've seen seemingly intelligent people not using their intelligence, not using their education. We study in school, we study in college. We learn about the organs inside the body. We learn about their functions. We learn what lungs are. We learn what the liver is. We learn pancreas, kidney, etc., etc. We learn the functions of these organs by heart. We understand. We score huge results, glorious grades in our ICSC, CBSC, etc., etc., Madhyamik. But how many of us do execute that learning, do execute that knowledge? My understanding of life is, I don't want to inject or ingest any additional chemical inside my body, which is a toxin. Because my understanding is, I am being injected. I have to ingest involuntarily a lot of toxin, a lot of chemicals via air, food, and water, without which I cannot live. So even if I don't want, there's a lot of toxin going inside. There's a lot of chemicals going inside, which is creating a lot of problems. We are fighting that. So we cannot live without those toxins, which is going there, which is going inside, those pollutants, which is going already inside the system of our body. But if I'm an intelligent person, if I'm really using my education, executing my education, I will stop any additional amount of chemicals and toxin to enter my body. That is my understanding. You may agree to disagree. Well, I can't force anybody with my beliefs. I can't force or impose my beliefs on anyone. You're free to believe anything that you want to. But I know for sure that this is what it should be. My education, my intelligence stops me from injecting, ingesting, or putting in any amount of toxins, any amount of additional chemicals, pollutants via cigarettes, via alcohol, via hookah, via gutka, and of course, what you call drugs, heroin, LSD, marijuana, etc., etc., etc. There are so many excuses, lame excuses, of injecting these chemicals. My only point of counter argument is, why? Why do you need pollutants and toxins and chemicals inside your body, inside your life? Why can't you live without it? There are thousands of other options to remain fit, to remain slim, to remain energetic. to counter your work pressure, to counter the tension in your life, to counter the depression in your life, to celebrate, to show friendship, to celebrate a festival, to celebrate an event of your life. There are so many other options, thousands and thousands of other options by which you can either celebrate or either can come out of a depression or counter the tension in your life. But why toxins? Why? I have done this in my life, all my life. Me being an actor, me coming from the entertainment industry, I want to point it out to all the young boys and girls out there who are listening. My life is very cool. My life is very fashionable. I live a very fast life. I party a lot, but without even one drop of alcohol, without one puff of cigarette, without one puff of hookah, without any what you call drug. Even without that, without them, my life is very cool. My life is very fashionable. I party, yes. The word party means celebration. The word party doesn't mean putting in toxins inside your body. We talk about physical abuse. We talk about good touch, bad touch, etc. We learn that from our school level. But what about us abusing our own body? What about that? We don't care. As we grow up, we have these two very, very important weapons with us: independence and money. As we grow up, we get a lot more independence from our parents. We become independent. And once we start earning money, the independence is doubled. It's multiplied. Major boys and girls, again, this is my experience, what I have seen in my family and everywhere what I have seen. The major derailment or the major, you know, a boy or a girl walking in the wrong path and making his or her life dark is because a boy or a girl cannot use this independence and money properly. My learning, my understanding of life is, if you can use your independence properly, you're going to get more independence. If you can use your money properly, if you can save it or spend it properly without ingesting or injecting toxins inside your body for the sake of whatever that causes, masculinity, the wrong meaning of masculinity, the wrong meaning of feminism, the wrong meaning of celebration, the wrong ways to counter depression, the wrong ways to fight sadness, the wrong ways to fight tensions in our life. If you do that, none of your masculinity, none of your feminism, none of your the wrong meanings of feminism, none of your popularity, none of your money, none of your big house, none of your power designation is going to help you, is going to save you if you put in toxins inside this body. It's blood cells, muscles, tissues. You put in the toxin, it is damaged. It can't be edited back. This is not a photograph where you can undo the edit. You cannot revert. So none of that bank balance and that car and big house and power and designation and your beauty and your masculinity and your six-pack abs and your popularity, none of that is going to save you. We have millions and millions of such examples in our history. It has not saved Chester, it didn't save Prince, it didn't save Heath Ledger, it didn't save Robin Williams, it didn't save Mr. Michael Jackson, it didn't save so many, Rajesh Khannaji, it didn't save Mr. Adi Barman, it didn't save Rishi Kapoor ji, it didn't save Sri Devi ji. The list is endless. We have a learning lesson out of these deaths. What is that learning lesson? The learning lesson is, These people thought that I have money, I have fame, I have talent, I have beauty, I have good looks, I have gari, I have bari, car, big house, international popularity. So I have become an Avenger. I have become somebody from the DCEU. No. You are not a superhuman. At the end of the day, you are just a human being made up of blood, cells, muscles, tissues. So that cigarette you're smoking, which is a drug, which contains hundreds of chemicals, fatal chemicals, chemicals of fertilizers, chemicals of used in batteries, chemicals used in rocket fuels, chemicals used in toilet cleaners, you're ingesting and injecting or puffing or putting it inside your body. It's creating a mess with your lungs. My question is why? Why? Why can't you have this basic sense that I have to keep this particular machine, the perfect machine given by God, Allah, Vaheguru, Bhagavan, whatever you say. We have to keep this machine perfect. How difficult it is. It's not difficult for me. And I am no sadhu, sant, and extraordinary person. I am not trying to prove myself extraordinary because I don't smoke, I don't drink. I think this is the basic thing that anybody can do. The alcohol goes inside the body for whatever lame reason. Partying and festivals and friendship and masculinity and feminism, whatever wrong reasons. It's a toxin that is going inside the body. And it's creating chaos inside the body. All these excuses, ki hum zyada nahi peete, kabhi kabhar peete, I drink occasionally. My counter argument is, what is poison occasionally? My education, my intelligence tells me that one drop is poison, one peg is poison, one bottle is poison. So even one drop going inside your body is doing that same chaotic functions inside and destruction inside as one peg or as one bottle. It's creating a chaos in your liver. And the funny thing is, we are calling alcohol as a toxin, and when it goes inside the liver, I'm not going into the medical mumbo jumbo. What happens inside the liver is alarming. Another toxin is formed by decomposing this ethanol, alcohol, which is even more powerful than ethanol. If you have done your biology and chemistry properly, it's acetaldehyde. And slowly but surely, your liver starts functioning improperly. And slowly but surely, this toxin, acetaldehyde, is not broken down properly and broken down anymore. So, ek to you are taking it inside, which is a toxin. And when going inside your body, the toxin is creating or manufacturing another toxin, which is even more powerful, even more harmful. Nothing can beat that. Nothing can beat that foolishness. Earlier, it was only the hookah bar. Now, hookahs are there, shishas are there in households. People are flaunting that they have a shisha bar in their house. Earlier, in the marriages, the people used to come and used to welcome the guests with roses, with itar, and now it's with a hookah pipe. And they're flaunting, and they're so proud. They're putting in tar, they're putting in formaldehyde inside their body and their guest's body. They're so proud. We live in a strangely double-faced world, where the manufacturers themselves are writing it on their product. They're sort of screaming. Such a hypocrites we are, and such hypocrites the whole society is. They're writing it on their product, on the cigarette packet, on the gutka packet, on the alcohol packet. It's poison, full stop. It is injurious to your health. It will cause cancer. Even if it is not cancer, which is the extreme end of it, you are harming yourself. My question is why? Why do you need to put in something inside your body in the form of cigarette, in the form of alcohol, in the form of gutkha, in the form of hookah, in the form of all these what you call drugs? And don't call the others, the cigarette, alcohol, gutkha, not drugs. And be very complacent about it. My question is, why do you need them inside your life? I don't need them. And if a very ordinary person doesn't need this in his life, yet lead a very fun life, yet lead a very fashionable life, cool life, why can't you? Why can't you take heed of this caution that the manufacturers themselves are writing? Why can't you understand? So this is a very simple formula, HCNF, health, career and family. Why can't you take heed? Why can't you pay attention to that? Why can't you follow that? Keep your health intact so that your career is intact and then your family should be intact after that. It's not only you who is getting affected, it's everybody around you who is getting affected. Why can't you rule your mind? Because these are the drugs which we are calling chemicals. These are the material drugs, as we are speaking about the cigarettes and alcohol and gutkhas and hookahs and other what you call drugs. And don't call the others drugs. And there are these abstract drugs. There are these abstract elements which are like drugs and which are like, you know, totally making you abnormal, the normal state, the emotional state. Health is not only physical health, mental health also, and it's creating a mayhem, a chaos in your mental health also. I call them drugs too. Drugs of pornography, drugs of online gambling, drugs of violence in games, drugs of disrespecting others, roasting, without even understanding the fact that it's the easiest thing to do, sitting in a room with a microphone in front of a camera and saying bad things about the others, criticizing about the others, is the easiest thing that one can do. The difficult thing is being even 1% of the other person. Trying to do actually without only criticizing, trying to do what he has done and maybe he or she has failed in that attempt, which you are criticizing. And trying to earn money, trying to make a living by insulting people. That is your profession. That can't be a profession. You are spreading negativity. And that is a drug. You are spreading that virus among the young generation. That how to be famous, how to be a celebrity, insult others, abuse others. The more you abuse, the more you are saucy, you are famous. Which is a virus that I'm fighting against day in, day out. How difficult it is to speak good about the others. And even if you don't want to speak good about the others, just let the other person go in his or her way. That's the only way to, you know, keep balance in the society. But see what has happened. In the name of being smart, in the name of being cool, in the name of being sarcastic, in the name of stand-up comedy, in the name of roasting, we are not leaving God, Bhagavan, Allah, Rabindranath Tagore, Netaji Subhash Bose, Prithviraj Chauhan, Mahatma Gandhi, sabko galiya de rahe. We are abusing everybody, we are being sarcastic on everybody, not realizing that these are jewels of our country. These are the people for whom we are proud of. We get our identity through them. We live in a democracy. Don't get me wrong. You need to protest. Yes, you need to put your foot down. You need to express yourself. But expressing yourself doesn't mean that you're going to spread these drugs. These emotional drugs, negativity, sarcasm, abusive language. That is creating a mayhem, chaos among the mental health of everybody. So this is another drug that I'm fighting against. How have you become civilized? how have we become civilized from the uncivilized people that we were, cavemen? How have we started living in society? How have we started living in a state, in a country? How have we united peacefully? It's because we have controlled two instincts in us. One instinct is the sexual instinct, and the other instinct is the violence in us. Think about it. Only if you can control your sexual instinct and the violence inside you, only then the society will be there, will exist. Otherwise, it will disintegrate. And that is exactly what is happening. The news that we are hearing, ghastly news, shocking news. The desperation to execute the sexual act has gone to such a level that even a six-month-old baby is not spared. Even a 16-year-old girl is not spared. Even a 35-year-old woman is not spared. Even a 50-year-old woman is not spared. And even an 84-year-old woman is not spared. So don't wait till it happens to your family, somebody in your family. That six-month-old baby can be your daughter. That 16-year-old girl can be your sister. The 50-year-old woman can be your mother. The 84-year-old woman can be your grandmother. So don't wait till it happens to you. Let us all create this individual awareness within us to stop this drug too, which is pornography. There is no place of pornography which is the most perverted form of emotional weapon that is totally destroying us, destroying the psychology of the youth of this generation, of not only this generation, of human beings all around. You cannot deny it, undeniable. And with the advent of smartphone and very easy access to all of this, it's there all out. What I do is, I keep myself very busy, because this mind, it's like a villain inside you. It's very destructive. It will prey upon your weak points and weak moments and will make you do all kinds of wrong things. It will discourage you from doing the good things. It will discourage you per se. Try to rule this mind. Try to be the king of your mind. Whether it's cigarette, whether it's alcohol, whether it's gutka, whether it's hookah, whether it's heroin, whether it's marijuana, whether it's LSD, whether it's pornography, whether it's abusive language, whether it's disrespecting others, rule the mind. Again, HCF, the H is only, not only the physical health. H means mental health also. You have to be fit and you have to be healthy mentally too. You may like me, you may dislike me, but the thing is that, give it a thought. Here is somebody from the entertainment world. Here is someone who was a marine engineer once, who had lots of independence and money in his life. Here is somebody who has seen it in his family. Here is someone who has seen it in his entertainment industry, people ending their lives like anything. I've seen it all. Here is somebody who is seeing it every day with many young boys and girls I'm in touch with. So these are not only stories that I've heard, these are whatever I've said, these are my experiences, these are my realizations in life, after seeing, after going through what I've gone through, and I'm going through at this moment too. So take care of your physical health and mental health, and stay away from all these drugs. You are a drug addict, mind you, even if you smoke. Even if you drink, even if you do hookah, even if you do gutka, even if you are an avid watcher of pornography, even if you try to disrespect others and spread negativity in the society, even if you spread hatred between religions, that is another negative drug. So you are a drug addict, so come out of it. Let's make the world a better place. Wishing all the dear soldiers of mine from Julian to School, Kolkata, the best things in their life. With all the love from the bottom of my heart. Wishing the same to the other Julian Knights and to everybody, to all the soldiers and well-wishers, people who are listening to me, people who like me, people who don't like what I say. But at the end of the day, I would like to tell them that I'm the biggest well-wisher that you can have. I'm not your enemy. Bobby Dada, Bobby Bhaiya, Bobby is the biggest friend, is the best friend that you can have. That's all that I have to say. I'm the king of my mind. Thank you so much.
তবে একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি কেউ কথা না কয় ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা কেউ কথা না কয় যদি সবাই রহে মুখ ফিরায় সবাই করে ভয় যদি সবাই রহে মুখ ফিরায় সবাই করে ভয় তবে পরাণ খুলে তুই মুখ ফুটে তোর মনের কথা একলা বলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি সবাই ফিরে যায় ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা সবাই ফিরে যায় যদি গহন পথে যাওয়ার কালে কেউ ফিরে না চায় যদি গহন পথে যাওয়ার কালে কেউ ফিরে না চায় তবে পথের কাটা তুই রক্ত মাখা চরণ তলে একলা দলরে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি আলো না ধরে ওরে ওরে ও ভাগা আলো না ধরে যদি ঝড় বাদলে আধার রাতে দুয়ার দেয় ঘরে যদি ঝড় বাদলে আধার রাতে দুয়ার দেয় ঘরে তবে বজ্রনালে আপন বুকের পাঁজর জ্বালিয়ে নিয়ে একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে যদি তোর ডাক শুনে কেউ না আসে তবে একলা চলো রে
ফাইনালি এট দ্য কনক্লুশন অফ টুডেজ ইভেন্ট I would like to express our gratitude to our Managing Trustee Ma'am, Mrs. S. E. Broughton. She has been a source of inspiration and a pillar of strength for all her students. I would like to say thank you to our beloved Chairman Sir, Mr. J. G. Broughton, who has been our pillar of confidence. A big and a special thanks to our Principal Ma'am, Mrs. Colleen Smith, who have always encouraged her students to take part in every event. Thank you, ma'am, for showing faith in Yellow House and giving them this opportunity today. Thank you to our Vice Principal Sir, Mr. Troy Frederick Ward, and our Junior Coordinator, Mr. Stanley Patcher Sir, for their help and support. A big and a special thanks to Mr. Bobby Chakraborty Sir, a well-known actor and social activist, for taking out his precious time for the students of JDS Kolkata. Thank you, sir, for your wonderful contribution. A special thanks to Mr. Niloy Chatterjee, sir, from Bongyo Samaj Bengaluru for his wonderful contribution. Thank you to the Yellow House Master and Yellow House Mistress for working hours behind the students for today's event. Last but not the least, thank you to the Yellow House students for your participation and contribution. Thank you from the entire Yellow House team for giving them this opportunity to work on the event of International Day Against Drug Abuse and Illicit Trafficking and make it worth remembering. Thank you.